That work, Shags?
Yeah, so I've been on the creatures team for, I think I was like 96 or 97 when I first joined. I've used a whole bunch of pads. Back then I was using the Taj pad and the Shane Powell pad, the Luke Egan pad, Luke Hitchings pad, Jake Paterson's pad on my longboards. So yeah, it was pretty cool to be able to go in and rub shoulders with those sort of guys, idols of mine. As the years went on, I was lucky enough to start designing my own pads. This was one of the early ones that I had. Still had the old square lock traction. The kicks were a little different back then. They're sort of a little bit more sort of bike ramp style. This was when I first got on tour, so 2001, 2002. This one was in 2002, like talking about using other people's pads. This was a Luke Hitchings pad that I cut down a little bit. But yeah, just the square lock has always been something that I've always loved. We upgraded to this pad. This is my 2007 world title board. This was when we started getting into different cuts in the mid piece. The kicks got a little bit better, not so drawn out and long. They sort of actually would stop your foot. The actual square lock was starting to get a little bit wider and would just hold up a little bit better. From there sort of went into, that's when I started going just the straight three-piece pad. We tried to break it up with just different patterns. This was one I just drew up. The kick was sort of got a little bit steeper again, but the square lock was always a staple of mine. This was my 2009 world title board. Yeah, this was the start of the evolution of my standard three-piece pad. We sort of just started playing around with different designs. I always thought it was sort of like mountains or something. I was really into snow and snowboarding, even though I can't do it. But we started playing around with like hole punches through the tail pad. 2014 J-Bay win. So the three-piece pad sort of just kept going. Just try to make it pretty simple, but the concept of the square lock and the three-piece was always there. We just changed the design so it sort of looked a little prettier from time to time. Around 2016 was when we introduced the Eugene pad. I was playing around with a little bit, some more wider boards. I just asked for a slightly different template, slightly wider and slightly longer. Kicks a little bit bigger, and that evolution into what you see today on the Eugene pad. This was my 2016 J-Bay board. And just got a couple of dings. It happens. Next one up, we have the twin pad. The twin pad is, it's a pretty simple pad. It's the shape of the Eugene pad. It's a little bit longer, a little bit wider, and just has the square lock, but it's just a flat pad and just a two-piece. I was playing around with twin fins and fun boards, and sometimes I just didn't want an arch bar because I was just moving up and down a fair bit. So I asked the team at Creatures if they would just make me a straight two-piece pad. Yeah, this is what we came up with. We've got some subtle little lightning bolts there from the old White Lightning days. So it's pretty subtle, but this pad's real fun. You can move your foot around and it feels grippy in every place. It's great for high performance twins, or it will work on any board if you really want it to. Lock light, all right. So yeah, there's a few different elements that help lock your foot in. When you're racing down the line or whatever, your foot's sort of up here, but then when you go into a turn, I sort of lift up, go over the arch bar and just lock my foot right in there. It locks into these little grooves here with the thermalite underneath. But then also the arch of your foot is actually in where the arch bar is. The arch bar slightly gets bigger as it comes out. The back of your foot can just lock straight into that kick tail. That little groove and the thermalite idea came from Idolo's pad, actually. I borrowed Idolo's pad and threw one on one of my boards, and I just really liked the way it felt. A cool thing about the new range of the Creatures pads is the EcoPure concept. Once it ends up in landfill, it starts biodegrading. Our boards are pretty toxic to start with, so if, yeah, anywhere we can help, we want to. Did you hear that, or? Yeah, Mum was trying to ring, but I think we got it.